G'day there, Pete Moriarty here with another set of G Suite updates. Google has made lots of changes in the last couple of months to their amazing product suite of G Suite. In this video, we're going to cover all of the latest updates relevant to small business owners and what you're looking forward to in Google's upcoming updates in the future. First up, we have news on Jamboard. Now, Google have been working away on their Jamboard product. If you don't know, Jamboard is the world's most amazing whiteboard, fully integrated with the rest of the Google ecosystem. And we have another review video that we've done on that. Check out the link to that one. But the Jamboard has not only been a physical product, it's now also available on the web. Now, initially it was first just in apps on your mobile devices, but you can now both create and edit jams on the web. So even if you don't have the hardware, you can actually use the same collaboration features of, think of it like a kind of digital scrapbook or whiteboard, but of course, being Googly, fully collaborative, and you can share it with your whole team using G Suite. Jump along to jamboard.google.com to give it a go and start your very first jam. Next up is an update for Google Drive, and this is one that we've been asked about for a very long time. Now, Google have just announced that the device approvals feature, which is available for registering new mobile devices into your G Suite account, has now been rolled out to Google Drive for the desktop. Now, what does that mean? Well, the device approvals feature allows you to flick a switch in your admin panel, and what that means is each time someone registers a new device, in this case, a computer running Google Drive, well, you get a notification as an admin on the admin panel inside of G Suite, and that device is not allowed to use that feature until you approve it. So it kind of means you're using like a whitelist as such for people to access Google Drive installed on their local machines. Now, what this is great for is for any of your staff who can access data inside of their Google Drive, it can be difficult to restrict where that data is accessed from. Business owners talk to us and they're concerned about, well, what if my employees, install Google Drive on their computer at home and then synchronize all my company documents to the home computer? What if they, want to put stuff on a work laptop and then plug in a USB and disappear with it? Well, this is one way of locking down that security just a little bit more, and it's called Device Approvals for Drive. Great little admin feature and helps you to improve the security on your G Suite account. Google have been doing a lot of work in the last year in the add-on space, and these are the third-party marketplace apps that connect to and enhance G Suite. Now, this program is open to pretty much any developer in the world, and they're able to build add-ons that enhance the functionality of G Suite. Now, not only did they kind of start in the Chrome world and then people started using the Google APIs to build add-ons to G Suite and help you get more out of the programs. But Google then launched their add-ons to both Docs and the other applications inside of Drive. So Sheets and Slides and even Forms as well have their own add-ons directory. Now, what Google is doing is they're trying to kind of unify these and bring them all into one place to make it simpler and easier for users, but also highlight some of those add-ons that are available for business owners. So you're not just using Google G Suite out of the box. I mean, really, when you start using add-ons and the extra extensions available, you really unleash the power of Google, because they're such an open company and they have such great APIs. What that means is that you can, as a third-party developer, build on the functionality of G Suite, and us as business owners and business employees end up with a much better experience. So what kind of changes are happening in the G Suite add-ons world? Well, for one, there's a new add-ons pane, and that's a unified experience where all of the add-ons are now sitting inside of G Suite. Now, this is soon to be opened up to developers to actually add their own apps inside of this pane, but for now, you can see there's automatically access to Google Tasks, Google Keep, and some of the other Google tools that you might already be using. Now, there's a short list of applications which are already working with this add-ons pane. Things like Dialpad and other apps that have been pre-approved by Google. But this one add-on experience, which is now available inside of Gmail, inside of your calendar, and inside of your Drive as well, is going to be the one place to go to for all of your Google add-ons right across the G Suite ecosystem. Now, within that add-ons pane is Google Tasks, and this is something we haven't spent much time talking about just yet because we tend to use third-party task management systems for our tasks, but Google are finally putting some effort into tasks. They've been around for a long time. They used to sit inside of Gmail, tucked away, and they weren't really all that useful. But Google are putting a lot of effort into their tasks app. There's now a tasks app for your iOS or Android devices, so you can get task notifications on your mobile. And what Google used to call reminders, they've now rolled into tasks, so you can migrate those reminders into tasks, and they're also appearing and integrating with your Google Calendar. So expect to see a review video coming up from us in the future on Google Tasks and how you can use them, what our experience has been. Right now, it's still kind of embryonic. It's still building its way up there to being useful, but Google are at least putting some effort into there, which is great. And that's all part of Google's add-ons push. Now let's get along to the biggest news for this month, and that is that Google is celebrating their 15-year anniversary of Gmail, which is pretty cool. They're now over 1 billion users on this product. I think it's nearly 2 billion users by now. It's absolutely awesome, and not only does Gmail help everyone with their personal email all over the world, but of course it's the bedrock of Gsuite and our business applications. So a couple of key updates that have come to Gmail, which I'm gonna share with you, including one super important tweak that has just happened, which is gonna make a lot of long-time users of Gmail very happy. First up is the scheduled send, which is being rolled out this month. Google are now mimicking what you used to be able to do with third-party add-ons and extensions, bringing it right into Gmail. It allows you to schedule sending an email at some stage in the future. Now, this integrates beautifully with the mobile and, you know, with your drafts and with everything else, but the scheduled send is a great little feature if maybe you're working at 2 o'clock in the morning and you want to send out a proposal to a customer, but you don't want to make it look like you're working at 2 o'clock in the morning. Or maybe for you, if you've got something in the future and you want to remind yourself to send that email to follow up or ping someone, but you don't want to have to manually set a reminder in your calendar or your diary. Next up is secure send. So Google actually call this confidential email mode. And what this allows you to do is send an email which can only be opened by the recipient. And there's a couple of different options there. You can set some parameters on how long it can be opened for and, you know, how long it lasts and those kind of things. But the great thing there is that that works not only with Google users, but also with anyone who's a Microsoft user as well. That's a great little feature for upping the security on the emails that you send. That one is still in beta mode, but it is slowly being rolled out to everyone and will eventually be released in full very soon. Finally, Google are finally changing the way that threaded conversations work. Now, one of the biggest bugbears that we've had with threaded conversations, or Google calls the emails conversation mode inside of Gmail, is that they bunch together emails that sometimes shouldn't be together. Now, if you send an email out to multiple people and it has exactly the same subject, Google will actually bunch all of those emails together because it thinks it's the same conversation. Or if maybe you get an alert every time you get a new lead on your website and all of those come in with the same subject, well, again, it bunches up all of those emails. And that frustrates the hell out of me. And for many of our customers, they've actually completely switched off conversation mode because it was just too annoying for their daily workflows. Well, thankfully, Google are actually finally changing the way that these conversations mode works. And what that means is it will only bunch together emails that have the same email headers, which means that they literally have to be a part of the same conversation thread. It will no longer do it for automated alerts or when you send out emails with the same subject to multiple recipients. Now, this is still being rolled out over the next couple of weeks, so don't expect this to work straight away. But if you've switched off conversation mode because of that, then I strongly recommend you give another go, switch it back on. Now that's a wrap for the last bunch of updates. Now, of course, it takes us a couple of months or so to get these updates out to you. And if you want to get access to all of the latest updates, then you might consider being a part of our private community. Not only do we cover all of these updates every single fortnight, but we go into deep dives onto how to use the new features. And of course, you've got our concierge team on call for any help you need rolling out or switching on these new features. In fact, if you don't want to bother with any of the technical details of your Gsuite account, well, you can just send a message off to our team or give us a call and ask our concierge team what you want to get done, and they'll just get it done for you. It's all a part of our concierge service. And to check that out, head along to itgenius.com. And if you want to strike up a conversation with our team, we'll be very happy to work you out. Till next time, we'll catch you in the next one. Cheers.